Hello dear students, very good morning. Welcome back to e-learning program initiated by Vidyadhish Vidya Sankul under the guidance of Dr. G.M. Sutaria sir. So this is our 29th lecture. In previous lecture, we have completed question 13 in that 8. Today we have to discuss question 13 in that B, right? Ramesh holds 600 equity shares of rupees 10 each in a company. He had paid application money at rupees 3 per share, allotment money at rupees 2.5 per share. So, see how they have demanded total 10 rupees. With application, the company has demanded 3 rupees. With allotment, company has demanded 2.5 rupees, right? And with first call, but could not pay first call money rupees 2. 2 rupees first call. Barabar? Pachisu kitu che? The company forfeited above shares before making final call. Final call ni amount su hai. 3 plus 2 plus 2, that means 7.5. Final call the amount is 2.5. But Aji Sudhi, final call demand kariyo nahi. Final call demand kariyo any pehla chute share forfeit karine kaida. Kya Sudhi kitla rupees demand kaya chai? 7.5. Right? Total kila rupees demand kaya chai? 7.5. Itle equity share capital ma apre su lakho padse 7.5, not 10. Right? Sukam apne avu karsu because final call na 2 rupees demand 2.5 rupees demand kari any pehla chte apne share forfeit kari gaya tha ab 7.5 ma ki shareholder is 3 ane 2.5 pay kari dita che 2 rupees pay kiya nahi any apne effect apvani che samjhanu no samjhanu hoy to thodu rewind karo fari var sambhlo ane samjho chata pan doubt hoy to tame mane puchho barabar तो फॉर्मेट ड्रो करो 3/4 पेज नो गिव द हेड जर्नल एंट्री पर्टिकुलर्स अलग debit rupees credit rupees right now the first transaction will be for forfeiture right so here premium is not given so we have to write the simple forfeiture entry and that is equity share capital account debit to equity share forfeiture account to call in arrears account right In arrears, we have to write the unpaid amount. First of all, in capital, see how much shares we have forfeited. We have forfeited 600 shares into till the date we have demanded only 7.5 rupees because final call is left to demand, right? Then in forfeiture, we have to write the amount which has been paid by the shareholder, that is 5.5. And shareholder has not paid, that means Ramesh has not paid 2 rupees, right? So the amount will be 4,500, 3,300 and 1,200, right? Into bracket, B, 600 shares of Ramesh are forfeited by a company before for non-payment of first call money before making final call. फाइनल કોલ ડિમાન્ડ કર્યો એની પહેલા જ તે આપણે ફર્સ્ટ કોલ ના રૂપિસ પે નોતા કર્યા એટલે એના શેર ફોરફીટ કરી દીધા રાઈટ સમજાણી સી આઈ એમ રિપીટિંગ ધીસ ટિલ ધ ડેટ વી હેવ ડિમાન્ડેડ 7.5 રૂપિસ રાઈટ 3 રૂપિસ વિથ એપ્લિકેશન 2.5 વિથ અલર્ટમેન્ટ એન્ડ 2 રૂપિસ વિથ ફર્સ્ટ કોલ આઉટ ઓફ ધીસ 3 કોલ He has not paid the amount of first call. Right? That amount we have written here. Till we have not demanded final call. Right? That's why we will not mention that amount in capital. Right? Demand is no karu hoy to apne kya the kahi shikwana ke atla e pay kari di thi ose. Right? Atyar sudhi apne kitla demand kiya the 7.5. To calculation kitla e thai 7.5. The forfeit kya re thai che check karwan. Clear? Now the second entry. Second entry will be for reissue. Underline, then leave one line, and next second. See, for that, in the question, company reissued all these shares at discount of rupees 4. That means total kitla ma issue kero chhe atyar sudhi 7.5. Ema thi apne discount kitlu aipo 4 rupees na. So, we have to write the last entry of reissue in the format bank account debit. Equity share forfeiture account debit to equity share capital account. In capital, we have to write 600 into 7.5 because we have reissued all the shares. Right? So, the amount will come here 4500. Out of 7.5, we have given discount of rupees 4. So, here we have to write 2400. That's why 7.5 minus 4. That means we have demanded only 3.5 rupees. Right? And the amount will be 2100. The bank of reissue entry will write later. Before that, write down this. Right? Reissue of 7.5 because you forfeit kareu directly so kari na kyu reissue એટલે કે હજી reissue કરતા પહેલા પણ final call demand કરેલો નથી right so in bracket we have to write bin 600 forfeited shares are reissued at 4 rupees discount before making final call. Bracket over, underline. Leave one line, then next the third. The third entry will be for capital reserve. And the entry is equity share forfeiture account debit to capital reserve account, right? And the entry will be capital reserve. The formula is capital reserve is equal to forfeiture credit minus forfeiture debit. Now see, here we have forfeited 600 shares and we have reissued 600 shares. So the simple entry will come, right? So in first entry we have credited in forfeiture 3300, and in next, that means second entry, we have debited 2400. That means the amount of capital reserve is 900. Into that day, bill balance of forfeiture account is transferred to capital reserve account. Break it over. Underline, leave one line, then make again one underline and write here the word total and do the total by yourself, right? And with this we have completed this sum here. Write down this. Now we will discuss the third sum. Again draw a format of 3/4 page. First, right? Company forfeited 400 equity shares of rupees 10 each. Sorry, of rupees 100 each. Like a share mein face value suche 100. Issued at premium of 20% on face value. Rupees 80 per share including premium are called up on this share. Like a share upar atyar sudhi kitla demand kya chhe? 80 including premium. Barabar to 100 na 20% premium, that means profit is 20 rupees. Till the date we have demanded total 80 rupees including premium. That means for capital the amount is 60 rupees and for premium amount is 20. So total we have demanded 80 rupees. Clear? Next. For non-payment of allotment money at rupees 50 including premium. This shares were forfeited before making first and final call. That means, rough calculation karo. So, tamare karvi hoy to tame journal entry ni niche calculation karjo. Barabar? Journal entry ni andar no karta. Application, allotment, first and final combined. Barabar? Total kila demand kira cha 100 plus 20 rupees se na cha premium. Total 120 demand karwana chahiye. Emaathi first and final call hajee sudhi aapne demand karo nahi. Barabar? Atyar sudhi kitla demand karela chahiye? Total 80 rupees. Emaathi 20 rupees premium na chahiye. To 60 rupees se na hoy capital. But 20 rupees se ma demand karo chahiye clearly kahi didu chahiye allotment. Right? Barabar? Ane allotment ma kitla total demand kira chahiye? 50 rupees. Barabar? So 50 mathi 20 rupees allotment na hoy. Arre, પ્રીમિયમ ના હોય તો 30 રૂપિયા અલોટમેન્ટ ના હોય 60 માંથી 30 અલોટમેન્ટ હોય તો એપ્લિકેશન માં કેટલા ડિમાન્ડ કર્યા હોય સી એપ્લિકેશન માં પે કરી દીધા છે અલોટમેન્ટ ના પે કર્યા નથી અત્યાર સુધી ડિમાન્ડ કેટલા કર્યા છે ટોટલ 80 રૂપિયા બરાબર 30 રૂપિયા એપ્લિકેશન ના 50 રૂપિયા અલોટમેન્ટ ના અલોટમેન્ટ માં 20 રૂપિયા નું પ્રીમિયમ અને 30 રૂપિયા કેપિટલ નું રાઈટ એ રીતે ટોટલ કેટલા થયા 80 રૂપિયા સમજાણું એટલે કેપિટલ માં શું અમાઉન્ટ આવશે 60 પ્રીમિયમ અનપેડ સી પ્રીમિયમ અલોટમેન્ટ માં છે ને અલોટમેન્ટ પે નથી ગયું ફોર નોન પેમેન્ટ ઓફ અલોટમેન્ટ મની એટ રૂપિયા 50 નો સમજાણું હોય લેક્ચર સેજ રિવાઇન્ડ કરો ફરીવાર સમજો બરાબર એટલે કેપિટલ માં લખવાના આવશે 60 પ્રીમિયમ માં લખવાના આવશે 20 20 પ્રીમિયમ ના અનપેડ છે એટલે આપણે પ્રીમિયમ એકાઉન્ટ ડેબિટ કરવું પડશે ધેટ મીન્સ From format, we have to write the second entry of forfeiture, right? So, if you want to write down this, then you can write down, pause the video and write it down. Equity, share, capital, account. डेबिट सिक्योरिटी प्रीमियम अकाउंट डेबिट टू इक्विटी शेयर फोर फीचर अकाउंट टू कॉल इन अरियर्स अकाउंट See, from capital we have demanded 80 rupees, sorry 60 rupees, right? And number of shares are 400. So 400 into 60 will come here. The out of 80, 20 rupees is of premium, and that amount is unpaid. That's why we have mentioned, right? Now he has paid only application money, and the application money is 30 rupees. So the amount will come here 400 into 30. The shareholder has not paid allotment money and the total allotment money is 50 rupees including premium, right? So 2400, 800, 1200, 2000. Bill. Have they given the name of shareholder? No. So we'll write bill 400. Shares of shareholder is forfeited by a company for non-payment of allotment money including premium before making first and final call. Break it over, underline, leave one line, then the next entry will be for reach. Right? Write down this. Done. Now the second. second entry is 4 reissued. So, this shares were reissued before first and final call at rupees 36,000 as fully paid up. Fully paid up means final call ली पहला इससे इन्हें final call ना amount ही pay करी थी. इसलिए आपने final call में transfer नो करी थी. तो लगभग पड़े call in advance, right? इन्हें total कितना pay करी था 36,000. तो general entry सो आउंसे bank account debit. इन्हें खाली 36,000 इस pay करी जाते. That means डिस्काउंट तो हसे इधर रीइश्यूइंग थर्ड एंट्री आपने लगवानी इक्विटी शेयर फोर फीचर अकाउंट टू इक्विटी शेयर कैपिटल अकाउंट वर्ष की तो छे फुल पेमेंट करी दी तो छे लेके फर्स्ट एंड फाइनल कॉल में पे करी दी तो छे या यहाँ से लगवानी टू कॉल इन एडवांस अकाउंट अब सबसे पहले आपने क्रेडिट नहीं अमाउंट लगा टोटल कैपिटल में कितना आउट से जे डेबिट किया चाहिए, राइट? लेकिन आप लगते हैं सुधी कितना डिमांड की रहा चाहिए 400 शेयर्स ऊपर 60 रुपीस डिमांड कर रहा चाहिए। टोटल शेयर कितना है इश्यू कर रहा चाहिए? दैट मींस फेस वैल्यू सोच है 100, 100 में भी 60 डिमांड करी ली था चाहिए 40 अजी डिमांड करवाना बाकी चाहिए तो ये ना एडवांस में पे करी ली था चाहिए राइट એટલે આનો આન્સર આવશે 24,000 અને અહીંયા આવશે 16,000 એટલે ટોટલ કેટલા પે કર્યા છે 36,000 24 + 16 40,000 40,000 - 36 ધેટ મીન્સ ડિસ્કાઉન્ટ કેટલા નો આવે 4,000 રૂપિયા છે સમજાણું ડુ ધ ટોટલ ઓફ ક્રેડિટ માઇનસ ડેબિટ ધેટ મીન્સ વી કેન ગેટ ધીસ આન્સર રાઈટ સી રિપીટ કરું છું અત્યાર સુધી 60 રૂપિયા ડિમાન્ડ કર્યા છે આપણે કેપિટલમાં લખી શકીએ 40 રૂપિયા એને એડવાન્સમાં આપી દીધા છે બીકોઝ ફુલ્લી પેડ અપ કીધું છે એવું હોય તો અન્ડરલાઈન કરી નાખો ક્વેશ્ચનમાં ફુલ્લી પેડ અપ મીન્સ નેક્સ્ટ કોલ લાઈ આપણને એને સાથે આપી દીધા છે 400 ઇન્ટુ 40 રૂપિયા 60,000 એના આપી દીધા છે હવે એને કેટલા પે કર્યા છે ટોટલ 36 કરવાના હતા કેટલા 40,000 40,000 માંથી 36 પે કર્યા છે એટલે 4,000 નું આપણે શું આપ્યું હોય ડિસ્કાઉન્ટ રાઈટ into bracket bin 400 forfeited shares are reissued at rupees 36,000 as fully paid up bracket over underline leave one line the next the third that will be the simple entry equity share forfeiture account debit to capital reserve account formula is capital reserve is equal to forfeiture credit minus forfeiture debit right because seen shares are forfeited and reissued so in first entry the amount of forfeiture account is 12,000 and in next entry the amount of forfeiture account debit is 4,000 so in capital reserve will transfer 8,000 8,000. Now write a bin by yourself. Bin will remain same as we have written in all the general entry of capital reserve. Bin, the balance of forfeiture account is transferred to capital reserve account and then close the general entry. That means do the total by yourself. Right? Write down this. Now we'll discuss question number 14. The head is Raj Machine Limited. So we'll give the journal entries in the books of Raj Machine Limited. Right? Now, for this question, draw a format of journal entry for 2 pages, because in this sum we have to write total 6 plus 2 plus 2 10 11 entries. Right? Question number 14. Okay, let's discuss the sum. Raj Machine Limited issues 12 lakh equity shares of rupees 10 each, on which amount was payable as under 3 application, 4 allotment, 3 first and final. Right? 3, 4, 3 application, allotment, and first and final combined. M karine total 10 rupees demand kiya. Right? Now, next. Company received applications for 14,70,000. See, we have issued 12 lakh, but we have received applications for 14,70,000. That means we have to return the excess application 2,70,000 in entry number 2 to bank account, right? So, next, excess applications were rejected and money paid on them was refunded. That means the entry number 2 in which we are writing to bank account. Right? Then, Akash, who was allotted 2000 shares, did not pay allotment and final call money. So, Akash has not paid 2 calls. Allotment and final call. Right? Then, Sunny, who was allotted 1200 shares, did not pay final call money. Sunny ye kaya pay nahi kiya final call. That means final call 2% pay nahi kiya and allotment 1% pay nahi kiya. Right? What is okay, Luche? Company forfeited all the shares on which calls were unpaid. Like, aap banne a troni entry. Troni installment check entry 6. Pachisu kaira. Akash ane Sanina shares forfeit kaira. Le 6th entry pachini 7th entry kai ase forfeit chani. 8th entry 2nd na forfeit chani. Awe tamne textbook ma combined forfeit chani entry aapi chha. Like, Sanini ane Akash ni banne ni combine aapi chha. Aapde alag alag lagsu. भले एंट्री आपने बे एक्स्ट्रा करनी पड़े, बराबर, but मिस्टेक ना चांसी सोच आते, जो तुम्हें कंबाइन कर सो, तो तुमने कैपिटल रिजर्व फाइंड करो ही डिफिकल्ट बन से, इले बे एंट्री फोर फीचर नहीं आउसे, सेम आउसे, खाली अमाउंट वाला चेंज है, 7th हाउस है आकाश नहीं, 8th हाउस है सनी, बनने नहीं फोर फीचर नहीं, बची 9th और 10th बनने नहीं रही इशू, इले के पहला आकाश नहीं और बची सनी and 11th entry capital reserve ni common. Clear? So, we'll do the sum. Shares vachche te forfeit thiya nathi. Kya de thiya chhe? Throni call pati kya pachhi. Barabar? Ille total capital ma dasu amount aavse 10 rupees. First 6th entry, chhe aapne pahle thi study kari kya chhiye? A chhe. Barabar? Date aapi nathi. Ille aapne sequence aapsu. Sequence number 1. So, the first entry will be bank account debit to equity share application account. Total we have received 14,70,000 applications out at rupees 3 per share. Right? That means total we have received 44,10,000 rupees. Into bracket we have to write bin application money are received on 14,70,000 applications. Bracket over. Underline the second entry will be for transferring. That will be the also the common entry. Equity share application account debit. To equity share capital account. To bank account, because we have to return the applications, right? See, in application debit, we have to write the amount which we have credited. That means 14,70,000 into 3. We have credited 44,10,000. Out of that, we have issued only 12 lakh application. That we have to transfer in capital account. 12 lakh into 3. That means we have to return 2,70,000 applications, and the amount which they have paid is 3 rupees, right? And that amount is 8,10,000. And here 36 lakh, right? Now we have to write bill. Bill application money are transferred to equity share capital account and excess applications are returned. देखिए एक्स्ट्रा एप्लीकेशन जो आई थी ये बताने ना पैसा पाछा राइट राइट डाउन दिस टू एंट्री देन विल राइट द नेक्स्ट टू एंट्री इज फॉर अलॉटमेंट allotment. Third, in allotment first entry will be for demand. So the entry will be equity share allotment account debit to equity share capital account. So now we are having only 12 lakh issued shares into we have demanded 4 rupees, 48 lakh rupees. Into bracket we have to write bill allotment money are demanded on 12 lakh equity share. Bracket over, underline. See, in allotment we have made tick mark because one person has not paid the amount, right? That's why in receiving entry we have to debit calling arrears, right? So the fourth entry will be bank account debit calling arrears account debit to equity share allotment account. So So, in previous century, we have debited 48 lakh. That means we have demanded total 48 lakh rupees. Out of 48 lakh rupees, there is one person whose name is Akash, who is having 2000 shares, has not paid 4 rupees of allotment. That means he has not paid 8000 rupees. So, we have received only 47,92,000 rupees. Right? Into bracket we have to write billing allotment money are received from equity shareholders except on except 2000 shares of Akash because Akash is pay karna nahi, right? Break it over, underline. Hope you guys are clear how we have got this 47,92,000. 48 lakh minus 8,000, that means we have received 47,92,000, right? Write down this too. Done? So the next. The next two entry will be for first and final call, right? In that also, the first entry will be for demand and the second entry will be for receiving. So, the first entry will be the first, that means the overall fifth entry will be equity share. First and final call account debit to equity share capital account. Total 12 lakh shares into we have demanded 3. So the amount will be 36 lakh on debit and 36 lakh on credit. The billing will be billing first and final call. Money are demanded on 12 lakh equity shares. See, in first and final call, we have made two underline, right? Two tick mark. That means there is two persons who has not paid the amount of first and final call. So, the entry will be bank account debit, calling arrears account debit to equity share, first and final call account. Two person has not paid, Akash and Sunny. Akash is having 2000 shares and Sunny is having 1200 shares. Both of them has not paid 3 rupees. So, 6000 of Akash and 3600 of Sunny has not been paid. That means we have not received total 9600. Total we have demanded on first and final call 36 lakh rupees. So out of 36 lakh we have not received 9600. That means we have received 35,90,400. Right? The billing will be billing first and final call are received from equity shareholders except 2000 shares of Akash and 1200 shares of Sunny. Bracket over. So this is the sixth entry. Clear? Samjhanu? Che same as the khali allotment ni jagah kayo word hai first and final call and it so change the amount. Right? Write down this. So next entry is 7. The 7th and 8th entry will be 4-4 feature, right? Because they have given in the question C. Company forfeited all the shares on which calls were unpaid, right? સૌથી પહેલા ફોર ફીચર ની લખશું. ક્યાંય પણ ક્વેશ્ચન માં પ્રીમિયમ નથી એટલે સિમ્પલ એન્ટ્રી આવશે, રાઈટ? પહેલા આપણે આકાશ ની લખીએ છીએ. ઇક્વિટી શેર કેપિટલ અકાઉન્ટ ડેબિટ ટુ ઇક્વિટી શેર ફોર ફીચર અકાઉન્ટ ટુ કોલ ઇન એરિયર્સ અકાઉન્ટ. હવે આકાશના કેટલા શેર્સ હતા? 2000 ઉપર અત્યાર સુધી આપણે ડિમાન્ડ કેટલા કર્યા છે? ટોટલ ફેસ વેલ્યુ 10 રૂપિયા, રાઈટ? આકાશે સેના સેના પે નથી કર્યા અલોટમેન્ટ ને ફાઇનલ કોલ, એને ખાલી સેના પે કર્યા છે? ફર્સ્ટ કોલ. તો એને જે પે કરી હોય અમાઉન્ટ વિશે માં આવે ફોર ફીચર માં. સો 2000 ઇન્ટુ 3 વિલ કમ ઇન ફોર ફીચર એન્ડ ઇટ અરિયર્સ ધ અમાઉન્ટ વિલ બી 2000 ઇન્ટુ 70 રૂપિયા, રાઈટ? બીકોઝ એને ફર્સ્ટ કોલ નાઈ પે નથી કર્યા અને ફાઇનલ કોલ નાઈ પે નથી કર્યા, રાઈટ? સો ધ અમાઉન્ટ વિલ બી 20,000 ધેન 6,000 એન્ડ 14,000. ઇન ટુ બ્રેકેટ વી હેવ ટુ રાઈટ બિલ. બિલ 2000 શેર્સ ઓફ આકાશ આર forfeited by a company for non-payment of allotment and first and final call money. Back it over. Underline. Right? The next will be 4. Four feature entry 4. Sell. The entry will remain same. Equity share capital account debit to equity share four feature account to call in arrears account. Right? Now, see, total we have, total he is having 1200 shares and we have demanded 10 rupees. Right? Out of that he has paid the amount of application and allotment. That means he has paid 7 rupees. And he has not paid 1200 into 3 rupees. Only final call amount, right? So the amount will be 12,000, 8,400, 3,600, right? Bing will write later. Before that, write down this too. Hope you guys are clear. This is the full flip sum. Those 8 entries, that means here combined call is given, that's why 6 entry and then 3 entries, right? But here we have forfeited shares of 2%, that's why we have given the separate entry. Write it down. Being 1200 shares of Sunny are forfeited by a company for non-payment of first and final call money. Write it over, underline with pencil, leave one line, the next is 9. The 9th and 10th entry will be for reissue. See, for reissue they have given in the question and reissued all forfeited shares at rupees 7 as fully paid up. Atyar sudhi total amount demand kari chhe ke fully paid up ho jai. But kitla hai reissue kero chhe 7. Price kitli chhe 10. That means we have given discount. Right? Now, from reissue in a format, we have to write the third entry. First of all, we'll reissue shares of Akash. So, the journal entry will be bank account debit. Bank account debit. Equity share forfeiture account debit. To equity share capital account. The number of shares of Akash is 2000. And we have demanded 10 rupees till the day. And on this shares were reissued at 7 rupees. That means 10 minus 7. We have given the discount of 3 rupees. 14,000, 6,000, 20,000. Right? Into bracket we have to write B. 2,000 forfeited shares of Akash are reissued by a company at rupees 7. Break it over, underline. Leave one line, the next will be 10. The 10th will be for reissue of Sunny. Right? The entry will remain same. Bank account, debit, equity share forfeiture account debit, to equity share capital account. Right? Now see, the number of shares of Sunny is 1200. Into we have demanded 10 rupees. This 1200 shares are also reissued at 7 rupees. And the discount will be 10 minus 7. Same 3 rupees, 8400, 3600 and 12,000. Right? Write down this. Bing will write later. B, 1200 forfeited shares of Sunny are reissued by a company at rupees 7. Now we have to write the last entry, right? Underline, leave one line and 11. The simple entry, that is equity share forfeiture account debit to capital reserve account. Now, capital reserve is equal to forfeiture credit माइनस फोर फीचर डेबिट. आकाश एंड सन बने ना बदाज शेयर्स री इश्यू करी दीदा चेक राइट. એટલે આકાશ નું શું આવશે અને સની નું શું આવશે. આકાશ માં ફોર ફીચર ક્રેડિટ આપણે કેટલું કર્યું હતું ચેક કરો. ટોટલ આકાશ પે કે દાદા 3000 ઇન આકાશ અકાઉન્ટ વી હેવ ક્રેડિટેડ 6000 રાઈટ. એન્ડ ઇન સની અકાઉન્ટ વી હેવ ક્રેડિટેડ 8400 રાઈટ. Now, in Sunny account, in Akash account, we have debited 3 rupees, that means 6,000. And in Sunny account, we have debited 3,600. Right? Check karo and credit mate check karo, entry number 7 and 8. And debit mate check karo, entry number 9 and entry number 10. Right? So, the here amount is 0, 8,400 minus 3,600. Yes. The answer will be 4,800. Right? 4,800 in debit, 4,800 in credit. Into bracket, you will write bill balance of forfeiture account are transferred to capital reserve account. Here the sum is not complete, you have to do compulsory the total. Underline, leave one line, then make again underline. Write here the word total, do the total by yourself and make double underline in column of debit and credit rupees. Right? Hope you guys are clear with this full-fledged sum. Right? This sum will be asked in 8 marks. Your today's homework is illustration number 11. Illustration number 11 is your today's homework. Right? We'll meet in our next video lecture and we'll do another sum. Till then, stay home, stay safe.